like to show you how to use Google Slides in some very non-PowerPointy ways. I have four examples to show you, and this highlights how you can use Google Slides as more of a graphic design tool than a presentation tool. This first example is courtesy of Eric Kurtz. You can follow him and learn more at controlaltachieve.com. Eric has a lot of great examples. This is an example of creating simple comic strips in Google Slides. So it's really basic. He's just using shapes and some icons for the penguin and the robot that he gathered from the web to create a simple slide comic strip with speech bubbles. This particular one is designed to talk about osmosis, the scientific term. So very simple, again, not designed to be used as a presentation, but just a design tool with simple shapes and text. Next up, this is an example that I built. This is an interactive slide presentation where individual students or a group of students would research a topic. So this is World War II. Everybody takes two or three of the different figures of World War II on here and completes this page. The interesting thing about this is that rather than viewing this presentation linearly by clicking on an image, it takes you to that person's slide. And then if we click on the corner in on this metal here, takes us back to the home screen. So click on Rose of the Riveter, and then it takes her to takes us to that page. So I'm doing that. It's a very simple process. We're just going to click on an image, go to Insert, Link, but rather than linking to a website, we are linking to a slide within the presentation. So in this case, slide 8. And so clicking on that takes us to the particular slide there. Example number three is a pretty spectacular one. This is by Josh Nichols, who is using Google Slides to create stop motion animation of sorts. So this is an unbelievable slide presentation. This is actually 1,005 slides long. And you really don't get the full scope of this until you click on Present. And what we're looking at here is stop motion animation. So I'm going to go ahead and begin advancing the slides very rapidly. And you can see that he has programmed in just by moving each shape one frame at a time, an introduction to all of the Greek gods. It's really cool. I especially like how the animation from one scene leads into the next. So the spear, for example, is going to go in and show us about Apollo, and then we'll go into music and so on. And so this continues, shows us all of the Greek and Roman gods. This is a pretty epic presentation, a really cool project that you can do in Google Slides. Last example that I'd like to show you is courtesy of Ryan O'Donnell. I will link to his website in the description for this video. Ryan creates all kinds of great templates. This is a Time Magazine template that he created. And the idea here is that students can create a magazine on a particular topic they're learning about. So the first thing you'd want to do is go into the page setup and change the dimensions of your presentation to whatever size you want it to be. So if it's a magazine spread, typically, you know, like 11 by 17 or something like that. And then you'll go in and kind of build out these mock page spreads with text boxes in kind of a rule to divide the page in half. Because this is a Google presentation, one of the cool things that you can do is embed video into your magazine. This makes it more of an interactive thing. And kind of similar to the other examples I've shown you, when you go into present mode, this looks really slick, really does look like a magazine. You could even add transitions to kind of emulate a page turning. And if we go to the video page, we can actually play that video right here on the screen. So these are four examples of how you can use Google Slides as a graphic design tool rather than just a regular presentation tool. I'll go ahead and link to each of these examples in the description of this video so that you can open them and check them out.